All right, so I want to briefly talk about the OpenAI announcement for GPT-4.0 Mini. Now, this has me very excited. Christmas really does come in July sometimes. So, for those of you that are unaware, OpenAI's most powerful model at the moment is 4o, which I've been using for certain chatbot applications, mainly around the assistance API. But one of the drawbacks to 4o is the cost, right? I just spent $20 testing one bot over the weekend, pulling some files and, training it on doing the vectorization and the knowledge base and hitting it. Just cost me $20 to test it over the weekend. So let's go through this announcement real quick. Exciting news. Today we introduced GPT-4.0 Mini, Mini-Me, new and affordable intelligence. So this 4.0 Mini outperforms 3.5 Turbo in textual intelligence. And another reason why I'm really stoked is I've been spending a lot of time in Chatbot Builder. And for those of you that are unaware, when you make a new Chatbot Builder account in the Settings tab, they give you an OpenAI key that's automatically linked in here, but 3.5 Turbo 16K is the only model that you can use in this base account. And for you to upgrade and use 4o, you have to disconnect this key and put your own in here. Now, I've been doing this for a few of my chatbots recently because there's a certain functionality that 4o allows me with calling functions. And so my hope is, now that we've got 4o, we're going to just replace 3.5 completely, which means that the overall output and quality of responses for all of our chatbots that are built through Chatbot Builder, like the sea level's rising, baby. Like everybody's, hands in the air, let's do this. So, just from a quality output textual intelligence perspective, we've got 82% on whatever this test is compared to 69.8%. But here is where I'm like, woo, yes, Connor. GPT-4.0 Mini is more than 60% cheaper than 3.5 Turbo, priced at 15 cents per 1 million input tokens and 60 cents per 1 million output tokens. I think 4.0 is like $5 for both of these. So this is a huge cost savings for anybody that's using 4.0 right now. Drop to 4.0 Mini. We're cooking with grease here. Okay. Modalities. GPT-4.0 Mini supports text and vision capabilities, and we plan to add support for audio and video inputs and outputs in the future. And then, of course, our standard multilingual understanding over 3.5 Turbo. With its low cost and latency, 4o Mini works well for high volume tasks, passing a full code base or conversation history to the model, call sensitive tasks that require fast responses. Like 4o, 4o Mini has a 128K context window, supports up to 16K output tokens per request, and has a knowledge cutoff date of October 23. So, this is a huge win for chatbot builders, right? Because what we are going to be able to build out of the box through chatbotbuilder.ai as soon as they figure out this integration, which I'm sure Ryan is, hammering at the keyboard right now. How do I get this integrated and fast enough? Because his Facebook group and the Discord, and the first thing that happens with a new model with all these chatbot builders is when, how can I access the new model? I'm the drop down feature. I can't click this and immediately put it in my bot, right? And then the chatbot builder platforms are like, you can talk with these at any time using your own API calls, yada, yada, yada. But either way, I'm excited to have this based functionality. Give me 4o Mini in here, which is cheaper and smarter than 3.5 Turbo. And then I'm hoping in the assistance API that using 4o Mini is going to allow me to call the functions the way that I've liked doing right now inside of Chatbot Builder. Hope to have more videos coming out on that. And you know, maybe it's kind of nice that I haven't made a video on that with 3.5 Turbo, because there was some limitations that may not even exist anymore. So this is a quick one, but I wanted to provide my initial thoughts here. And for those of you that are looking for the full article, this is up right now on the OpenAI website. 4o Mini going to replace 3.5 Turbo. This is good stuff. We got some comparisons going. For those of you that were, you know, complaining about the 4o cost, which, you know, consider me in this camp, it's only a matter of time. Like, this is kind of the same story that we're getting through all of these models, right? Which is, okay, our new and shiny best model, it's going to come in at a higher cost point. We're going to have people using it. Then we're, you know, the next one's coming. So this 4o's got to get cheaper. Here is their, you know, solution slash version to that. So even though some of these testing costs and production costs can kind of be get high initially, it's only a matter of time before the token cost comes down and becomes commoditized and, you know, something that we may not have to, you know, take as much consideration for or workarounds or something. So this is a big win for everybody that's using these models, and huge win for anybody inside of Chatbot Builder AI, because all of your bots across the board are about to get smarter, cheaper, and have more functionality. More to follow. Happy building out there. Talk to you all soon.